But forgive me for missing some words. Inshallah, the brother will help me, inshallah, find some vocabulary that I miss. Anyway, this is from the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that we gather with each other here in this mosque. And this is one of the big mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala put us each other to seeking knowledge, to talk about Islam, to cooperate with each other, to find the correct path of Islam that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has revealed in his book. And he has sent his prophet Muhammad to guide the people to this path. So talking about this path is the most mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you see, many people, they're sitting in many gathering, they're talking about dunya, they're talking about sins, they're talking about a lot of things. So we have to thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that He came up, that He came us here. He brought us here. Exactly. So I'll start with a story. It has many benefits. And it gives us a lot of lights. I will not talk about the stories of Prophet Muhammad or other prophets. I talk about a story about a very famous man. He's one of the head of Ahl-Sunnah or Jama'ah. He's very famous. And he's Shaykh Muhammad bin Abdul-Wahhab. And you know a lot of people who are upon bid'ah. They are calling the follower of the Sunnah Wahhabi. And they are claiming this as to keep the people away from them, even though they don't know, they haven't read any book of Shaykh Muhammad al-Wahhab. Shaykh al-Wahhab, rahmatullahi alayhi, his life has many, actually, many many lessons, and has a lot of things happened in his life, but I will not talk about everything. I talk briefly about his life, then we'll talk about some benefits that we can gain from this story. Shaykh Muhammad bin Abdul-Wahhab, rahmatullahi alayhi, he was born in the year 1115 in a small village called Ruyayna. It is in the Arabian Peninsula, Najd. He grew up in an Islamic community. His father was a big scholar of Madhab, Imam Ahmad bin Hanbal. And his grandfather, he's well known at that area, but the people used to call him the Mufti of the Arabian Peninsula at that time. So he grew up in a good family, in a knowledge family. But most of the people at that time were upon bid'ah. They're not upon bid'ah only, they're upon shirk. The situation in the Arabian Peninsula and other countries at that time, the people worship graves. They worship trees. They worship caves. They worship a lot of things. The Ruyayna, the city that Shaykh al-Wahhab was born in, it has 17 trees that people worship. And they believe in it, some people will go. And even though they have a tree, nakhl, what do you call nakhl?
Tree.
Yeah. Some ladies, they are seeking husbands, they came to this tree, and they are asking this tree to give them husband before the end of the year. Even though there were many graves in the Arabian Peninsula, people think about them, and they are asking them, they are sacrificing for them, they are taking them as a wasila, they call it Shafi'a,
Benamina.
Yeah, intercession. Intermediate. It's like the way that Mushrikun did with Prophet Muhammad. They were worshipping stones, they were worshipping statues, they were worshipping angels, and they claimed that they will raise them to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He grew up at this society, and he was upon most of these aqidah, the people that Aqidah spread in the Arabian Peninsula. But Alhamdulillah, Allah opened his mind and opened his eyes. he was influenced by the books of Shaykh Islam in Tanya, and he was clever. He grew up reading the Quran and reading the translation of Quran from the major scholars like Tabari and Kathir. He went also to the tafsir of al-Bukhari, Muslim, all the major books. He was influenced a lot about from the books of Shaykh Islam ibn Taymiyyah and ibn Qayyim. And he knew, because the evidence of Tawheed is very clear in the Kitab al-Sunnah, and the evidence are very clear that most of the people acting are upon shirk, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forbid in the Quran. So he started telling the people that you are upon shirk, upon bid'ah. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said this in the book. Allah said this in the book. And a lot of people didn't listen to him. So they opposed his da'wah, but he still continued. He remembers the Quran when he was about 10 years old, and he used to debate a lot with all, with his father, with his grandfather, with most of the scholars that he take knowledge from, and with the people. He was very active, even though that he was about 14 years old. This Shaykh Anwar, when he became about 18 years old, he went to Mecca to make Hajj. He is 18 years old, and he had the intention to spread the da'wah in the whole world, even though he's alone. He came to a Kaaba, he stand between the Hajar Aswad, the black stone, and the